Sorry, I'm back again. It's creeping up on midnight of the 23rd, or yeah, I think it is. I got the right day. I got to make sure I can sleep in the morning. I may be staying up too late. I'm sorry, earlier in comments, the guy asked me if I was being gang stalked, and I said no, only by the hobo crowd, apparently, and then I added that I have had a lot of problems with the members of a certain church, but wasn't sure, don't have full access to their membership list. And today, because what just happened, I was, you know, you can look back and see the video of the airsoft or Nerf gun or whatever that was shot right where my body would be when I was gone into 7-Eleven. They fired from the parkway through there. But people circle around here all the time because of the traffic management layout, which actually I approve of. It does good for the businesses and does good for that intersection without having to turn that into a gigantic intersection. And anyway, I'm going to try to make this brief. I was relaxing and I haven't eaten even like a third of the food that was brought to me. I can't eat big meals. It was delicious. I only detected perhaps vegetable oil and one. I think the reason at my age, and I smoke, the reason that I still can smell and taste better than most people is because I don't use fragrances. And I've always hated closed air systems. You know, it's airtight, energy efficient, all that kind of stuff, you know? You have to have exchange of air, according to the American Lung Association, 11 times, or is it 12 times, per hour, or your lungs are going to be terrible. It's also going to affect you. Anyway, I was sitting here, in a car, a vehicle pulls up, and he doesn't pull in directly, kind of parks at an angle, waits a little bit, and then he gets out. He can tell that I'm not looking to read his plates. Gets out, and he comes up, and he violates basic rules. He goes, you know, Texas rules, and he goes, "What's your name?" Because he can't tell me my name, because that would be a giveaway if he is an Uber driver. It took me a minute or two to figure out what was going on. And what I haven't mentioned yet, sorry, I have to keep everything straight, is that about the time that food was being delivered to me and stuff like that, and coffee being fetched to my specifications, a guy launched this Christian Jew hate preachment about Jesus is the only way, you know? It's, yes, only, you can only, salvation is only found through our Lord Jesus Christ, and a vagina can take any size penis. He's telling me I'm crazy. Dude, vaginal tearing and stuff is evidence of forcible rape. And I sent this to my doctoral friends, and he was just, it was hilariously, he's violating Jesus' own commandments not to harass people. I think that's a book of Matthew. And he's personifying the evil Christians. And he may have been the actual fucker that at his cost and damage to his Uber account, he knows where I'm at. I've made too many videos at this location with a sign at the background. He sent that Uber driver at his expense, because they're going to ding him for a no-show. It's not going to be a few bucks. It's going to, you know, but he's rich. I'm sure he is. And of course, I reported him for misinformation and harassment. Anybody who's reading that, it says that a vagina can take any size penis is insane. You think that a man my size, with the way I was, can take a... No. It tears them up. Oh, God, some of you people are... You're trying to attack my statements about circumcision, how it used to be really prohibited here in Texas. And he actually tried to claim that in the civilized world, almost all men are circumcised. Oh, no, not really. Circumcision's on the way on the downswing in this country. Has been even in Europe for a long time. I'm pretty sure the Chinese don't do it. The Russians don't do it. In Africa, the Muslims circumcise the females. They don't do circumcision. They do genital mutilation to prevent any kind of sensation out of some psychotic. So, you know, it's kind of a mixed bag. I've got people that are doing it right and stuff like that. And then it's clearly I'm being gang stalked by Christians who hate Jews that will not convert. And shit, I've already had people rat on them. Being active on Nextdoor and other apps and stuff where they can communicate and tell people to stop giving me any assistance and stuff like that. And, you know, the cost of living, not just here in this area, it's way... Actually, I have a small oil and gas check that's way overdue. That would help a little bit. I'm talking about it most of a few hundred dollars. Sorry, I had a... So, you know, the problem is that for every decent Christian that you meet, like my best friend... There's probably 10 of them, like the fuckers that tried to put the ice pick in my neck. He was trying to do a conversion and try to do a condemnation. Actually trying to promote. I'm sorry. I know I got him, his channel disabled. He probably wasn't using it anyway. It's an attack. It's a kamikaze. It's a burner channel. Because nobody's going to attach his name to such insanity like that. Where I can screenshot it and then put it on my Facebook page, which is not in my name. And show Christians the insanity that runs amok amongst them. You actually said that vaginas can take any size penis. You're freaking insane. And if an actual human female reads those words, your channel is gone forever. It's not three strikes. It's you get the death penalty. I've had people on here, Jew-hating motherfuckers. Are Jews a race or a religion? Are you that? Yeah, you are. No, you're just, that's what we call actually a passive-aggressive kind of, that's a hateful. If you have any education, you know that we're not a race. We're a specific... a genetically specific ethnic group. And one of those definers is the colonate mutation on the Y chromosome, which rarely mutates. It's, you know, that's why men insist on paternity. That's why we have marriage, is because we carry a chromosome that almost never mutates. So we are both a genetically specific ethnic group, and also a religion. I hope I'm getting through to you this. So I'm calm. I haven't even taken any of my medication today. That young woman that came up behind me today and tried to give, got up right up behind me quietly, was left her car on the parkway. Came up behind me. I don't know. Pops up right inches away from me. If it had been Austin, I would have had, she would have been, something really bad could have happened. She could have died. You better think about that when you do shit like that. Don't come up behind some old man of Vietnam age. I didn't go to Vietnam. Has PTSD. Is taking PTSD medication to prevent, you know, rapid. I've already told you this before. Those, you know, those reflexive kill moves that I had to use during a large part of my life. So, I know it's not going to stop and stuff, and these are evil fuckers. And I can tell a lot of them created these kamikaze channels right when they started arriving here around 2020. Seeing a lot of those. I've seen a lot of channels that were, I've seen like times three of these kamikaze channels. They were literally created on the same date. And this, yeah, there in this area, there's a group of people that pretend to be hard workers, good workers for big corporations and front row Christians every Sunday morning and stuff, and good neighbors working on the next door app and, you know, volunteering for this and that. But in reality, this guy was dictating to me. There was no give and take there. He didn't, and he obviously has no scientific knowledge of reproductive organs. The foreskin of the penis is part of a huge expansion joint. You know, I didn't, when I was young and dealing with young women who were not virgins, but not stretched, I realized very quickly, because I'm a sensitive person. See, when you're uncircumcised, you don't build up those 16 layers of dead skin between. Otherwise, you only have one little layer of live skin between your nerve, and she has the same on her side. She has no buildup of dead skin, such as we find in the circumcised penis. The penis, I think, in my opinion, I'm going to tell you one more time, because I've examined a lot of black females, and this is going to sound racist as shit. I don't give a fuck what you say. I had a lot of black women, almost every one of them had what they call tilted uterus. Maybe that's because they started very young, and the men were not circumcised. They were, can be huge. You can actually, the guys that sometimes look like they're big is because it's people they don't understand. I'm sorry, I'm really getting, I just hate it when a complete idiot who knows nothing about the subject and is probably sitting there with some little 2-inch circumcised dick is trying to tell me that a vagina can accept any size. My point was is that early in life, I only used about half of mine until I found what I've, shit, I was like 20-something years old before I finally had a woman that I could tell upon approach that she had had a child. She had no stretch marks or anything, but that's the first one that I could actually go, you know, trying to not be too graphic here because that's a prohibition. Although I've seen disgusting channels and videos on, it'll come up, I'll hit a button accidentally or something, and I can't believe he wasn't up on the, as I recall, circumcision rate in this country has been going down for a long time. It's pretty rare in Europe and really doesn't happen much in Africa, the entire Asian continent. Don't know about Australia. And anyway, that's basically my point, is that the good Christians and regular viewers, I think they're doing the right thing. That's what happened tonight. But some people are going out of their way. They're obsessed. Because I'm not going to let you slide. When you try to murder me, you think I'm really... Hi, little bunny rabbit. She's coming right up to me. She is so pretty now. I'm sorry. Oh, gosh. That's the other one. There's actually two of them. The other one is, been watching them since they were juveniles. Little tiny little bunny rabbits. I don't know. It's, rabbits actually like to play. Maybe I'll tell you how they do it sometime, but right now I need to, you know, I'm going to repeat it one more time. You Christians, just in the last 1700 years have hunted, captured, tortured, murdered, been party of at least 10 million of us Jews. And you keep, and a guy even says, I keep an Israeli flag along with my American flag on my deck. No, buddy. Fuck you. He's kind of pretending that he's more. But then he said, I'm circumcised both in the heart and in the penis. Guy's a fucking nutbag. Towards the end of the Old Testament, they were already pointing towards what Jesus instituted as the new law. They were only already pointing to, we were already pointing to, God was already pointing to that, you know, it can't always be done in the proper fashion. So therefore, God makes plenty of exemptions to his own rules. Like I quoted the minor prophet, and he even quoted that. He said he lived a righteous life. No, you weren't. You were bullying me. You were dictating to me. You were doing everything that Jesus told you not to do. You were acting in a hateful, unloving fashion. When I sent that to a real Christian, somebody who has a doctorate and his wife is a professor, I'm not going to repeat what he said about you. We kind of have an understanding. He's a juris doctor. And I explained to him why certain laws are, like why there's no death penalty for lesbians. There's a death penalty for male homosexuals. You know, I've run into all kind of lesbians that don't know that they're actually exempt from the death penalty law. Midwifery, close relationships, women need assistance sometimes while reproducing the human race. I'm so sick and tired of fucking atheists and fucking jackass fucking Christians who think that their beloved sweet Jesus is the be-all, end-all. That's what them fucking Muslims think. They think that Allah is the final prophet. You know, I did check the dates. If you've watched my videos, the Muslim woman who handed me a $100 Visa card that was actually spent down to $30. Didn't actually say a word. She just kind of gave it to me and I said, thank you. And that was actually the day before Hamas launched their attacks. Muslims almost never were benevolent to me. I can't really remember any. Not any real Muslims. So I know I've gone 20 minutes here because I've had a cup of coffee. I've had a decent meal that was home cooked. And I want you to know this. I've got doctoral level witnesses. I screen shoot almost everything. I erase my videos immediately. You know, the only thing I keep in my memory, images are the screenshot proofs that I take and I send them to my best friend, who's also my attorney, who archives everything, has been archiving everything, all of our communications for I don't know how long. He's had the same cell phone number since like as soon as cell phones came in. You know, he can pay his bills. He always makes sure that he gets another model or another carrier that will take his, you know, transfer his number. Because he owns the number. I've had it memorized like forever. I'm sorry, I'm just on kind of one of them rants because it's somebody actually is so fucking childish that they spent money and damaged their Uber account by sending it to this specific address. What a petty little man you are. See, I'm going to repeat to you. What I'm seeing is the same jealousy that, I'm sorry, pardon me, it's my deduction after a lifetime, a long lifetime, of analyzing the scripture and history and everything else, is that in the revelations to Saint John, where the city of heaven, outside of that's paradise for the Jewish females and the Gentiles and stuff that believe in Jesus as God, shall go. It's quite precisely defined in the metrics and the materials and everything else and the size of it. And it's for the 144,000. See, that may not be up here in your Bible. It's actually there. 12,000 from each tribe, 144,000, who can sing that special song that only God. And from the throne of the Lamb, him, meaning him, shall flow the river of life, and so on. It actually makes a reference to what appears to be cannabis in that, Revelations chapter 22. And if you read the Hebrew text, God only chose us. We were the ones chosen to convey his laws. That's all we were chosen for. We were chosen to pass those. Yeah, exactly. We were chosen to receive and to pass those laws along to other people. And no one there is any description of, I have so much nerve damage in my right arm, it's beginning to shake a little. I got to try to sum up here. Nowhere in the Hebrew text can I find any description of heaven, really, and that we alone are chosen to occupy some special city of heaven in paradise. It only appears in the New Testament, the Jesus tale, and that's probably what got him killed. was, you know, one of his, well, no, that's supposed to be his revelations to St. John was, I think, was after his death and then ascension or whatever. I'm sorry, I may go 30 minutes here. I get on a tear. Because when you come out there and I can take screenshots of your shit and your rant about the vagina can take any size and it cannot. God, makes me think of a horrible case in my home county. And my doctor was in the ER when they brought in an 11-month-old baby that some crackhead had managed to penetrate by tearing her open from pubic bone to the coccyx, the tailbone. He said it was the most god-awful thing he'd ever seen. Just couldn't believe that any human could do that to a 11-month-old baby that has a vagina that's forming up. Anyway, I'm trying to make an extreme point. It's just the lunacy of the kind of crap that I've had to listen to lately. Y'all got some seriously fucked up Christians in this town. I'm telling you. And I've been polite to the guy who I'm pretty sure was behind the ice picking. Actually met him right here one evening. Funny he should be here. And then he pops up at 7-Eleven. There's somebody walking by. I may not have my glasses on, but I have excellent peripheral vision too, and acutely aware of motion, just like I caught the rabbit a minute ago trying to sneak up on me and play with me. They do this jumping over each other. One will stand still and the other will come at it at a 90 degree perpendicular and then jump, and the other one tries to get out of the way before he jumps over. Anyway, you can tell I'm not a hateful person. I was already going and telling you wildlife tales. My mom used to love the letters I would write her while I was out adventuring and traveling around the world. So especially about all the birds and animals and bugs and the mountains and all that stuff. I'm a good writer. My speaking abilities are kind of off lately because the back of my head, I've always got, you know, these problems that my brain is devoting a part to grinding away on. And one of those problems is that, compared to Austin and all the other places I've been since the unjust eviction of them from my own home from somebody who doesn't actually own any, has no equity in it. And I just, isn't it crazy how I get injured, have severe injuries, you know, 6 months before I began to run out of time. I could have possibly written a petition for extension, and I'm sure the judge would have granted it, but I'm getting to where I don't care. I don't like the people who are moving in next to me. I don't like most people everywhere. And I can tell you that my first, because actually there's been a kind of a change in population, but then also some of the true evil is coming out of the woodworks. It's the Christians who want me to come be part of their congregation and play their little games with them. And I keep telling them I'm a Jew. And that just makes their little things tumescent. They are just so hell-bent. To be able to go in and tell their pastor or something, I converted a Jew to Jesus. Because let me repeat what I've heard so many times and seen on so many videos is these ranting, like the guy who was trying to preach to me earlier, he separated every sentence in a long attack and dictation to me about how I can only be saved by Jesus Christ. You know, the people, and one guy actually said, you look just like one of the Pharisees that killed Jesus. And I said, excuse me? the Romans killed Jesus. Maybe I should. You people have all these rights and other things, and all these laws that protect you, everything from bankruptcy, that's God's law, debt forgiveness every 7 years. 49 years is the Jubilee year. 7 times 7. First laws against animal cruelty. First laws against the basic form of slavery. In a world in which slavery was, we brought you morals to a completely different mindset of humans. In the preaxial period, murder wasn't considered that bad, especially if you profited or gained from it and the other party didn't have enough peeps behind them for a vendetta. That's what God created, the cities of refuge for manslaughterers. God doesn't forgive murder, but in the heat of passion or self-defense, in some kind of fight or conflict, if somebody gets killed unintentionally, that's manslaughter. We recognize it in our law. Your laws are based on what God gave to us to give to you. We've done that. Now y'all act like a bunch of fucking animals. You Christians act like fucking animals sometimes. Really, you do. Especially when you find out that I'm not part of your gang. You're just so hell-bent. And I've seen so many people waste their whole lives trying to put them notches in their little Christian pistol of how many souls they've saved for Jesus. And you don't know how many times I've seen people like Hobo Shoestring totally get over on all these latently homosexual preacher kind of guys and just milk them for everything that they can get out of them. When in actually, they're an unremorseful, unrepentant, fake Christian. And this prosperity gospel shit? The prosperity gospel has got to be one of the, that's almost like the, as stupid as the cargo religion, which I've already explained, and I think in one video. Goes on, I think, down in the South Pacific. It's just amazing. It's fucking amazing. They've done it too. The people in this town, the Christians in this town that were acting the most generous to me turned out to be some of the most vicious and some of the most needy, emotionally needy. Even the first guy, he said to me, got rabbit's tip messing around with something back there. I do have to watch it though on the, actually, no, I think there's enough rock behind me where I, here. He actually, you know, he first kind of triggered me by doing the pill rolling, meth thing, but I forgave him because he's a string player. Then he invited me to dinner one evening. I told him, I'm not hungry, but I'll accompany you to dinner. He goes, yeah, I hate going anywhere. He said, I hate going anywhere alone. He has that loneliness gene strong. See, there's some of the Thanksgiving coming up on me. He's giving me all wrong. And then after, well, we were actually sitting in his driveway after he had already told me about his son, badmouthed his son, when he himself appears to be a meth user and stuff, and badmouthed his, called his wife, fat, and oh gosh, dude. Tells me you ain't had none in a long time. Because you know, when people act like that, then you're going to be like, I'm going to be the next one he's going to be talking about behind their back. And he said, I told him that most I would consider when he began was maybe in your backyard, you know, access to your flush toilet. He was trying to get me to move into his house. He wanted to use me like my brother used me when his marriage was disintegrating, as a buffer between two warring parties. People often think that I'm stupid, as they are. That's where you're fucking up. I'm not. And I hope this 35-minute plus 36-minute video will make some impression on you, that the minute you open your mouth and say something stupid or something that you think is okay, like, I don't like going anywhere alone. That's, for a man, that's like a total chick thing. Women are the types that will say, will you go with me to lunch? I hate going alone. You see where I'm going with this? God commands you to stand before white hair for a reason. I earned this white hair. And I've earned that kind of, my shoulders are kind of beginning to stoop at my age from decades of bending over examining things, biological things, rocks, and reading books and shit. You know, the real thing that can't be faked like you can on a computer on the web. Or so, to some people who do it right, I shall act right. And I'm sorry. People out walking this time of night is kind of unusual. I've got to get a look at this fucker before he gets out of sight. No. That doesn't look like the chick. It just looks like somebody who's apparently walked a hell of a long way just to... Actually, I don't know where the hell he went. There's no place around here that has shopping bags like that and is open at this time of night. And he or she couldn't have walked that far in that time, because I already, on this video, I marked when the person passed over there headed east and has already come back with a large shopping bag. And my immediate deduction is, based on what I know, is they had a shopping bag hidden in the jacket and they've stolen something. And now they're gone. Anyway, please. Yeah, I know I'm taking a long time here, but I'm trying to let you know that, please, most of you are just totally transparent to me. I've always been curious as to how all these people are so different from me, how they function. So I've spent, and it's critical in the biomedical area of research, I've spent a good part of my life doing. You have to be acutely aware of and analyze the human soul, the psyche, however you wish to pronounce it, as part of it, because of neurochemistry and all the other. So, especially the guy that I know, I've got that channel, it's gone for misinformation and for harassment. And pretty sure YouTube's going to swing my way on that one. And because they didn't put up there, only the commenter can see his comments. They didn't do it this, you know, it was just, he's gone. Okay, gone. Apparently I wasn't the first complaint on that channel. You know, for you Christians who say that Jesus is watching you all the time, y'all keep doing really bad, evil things. And out in public, lying your ass off, saying, oh, Jesus will forgive. I'm going to end with retelling the story one more time. At my family reunion, I was sitting by two of my cousins, and they were talking about, because I'm wearing a kippah, a Jewish skull cap. And they should have been told that we are Jews. Even on their branch of the family, they're still carrying Jewish, you know, DNA. They were talking about, here comes Starbucks delivery at midnight. Jesus forgives everything. Yes, he's so forgiving, he's so loving and everything. And I just calmly looked at him and said, yeah, I'm sure Jesus will forgive Adolf Hitler. Mm-hmm. Later on, they apologized and asked if I had hurt their feelings. I said, no, I've heard all this stuff before. I understand you weren't thinking. You're overwhelmed with your ardor and your passion, Christ-like passion. So, God is a forgiving God. I don't know if he'll forgive me, and I, compared to Adolf Hitler, I'm a fucking nobody, you know? In the world of being bad, you know, it's the guy that, according to Jesus himself, the guy that attacked me. He said, and that is all you shall receive. So, you know, you evil fucking Christians here, you people who are actually evil people hiding behind organized religion and the solace that it brings you and the congregational, the social benefit that you derive from being a total, complete phony and fake. Just remember, as Jesus said, I think it was the book of Matthew, that is all you shall receive, is that little bit of attention. And it was Jesus that created this worldwide envy of him naming us to be the ones to occupy the city of heaven in Revelations to St. John. He created this huge schism between the followers of Yeshua and we Hebrews, we Jews. See, some of you love Jesus, and I see him as, I'm tolerant. You can talk about him, but you better get it right according to the book. I've read all the translations. I've studied it more than you have. So I don't mind you talking about your faith, your trust in Jesus. You know, it says, a woman the other day was asking for clarification about faith in God, and I said, well, it's more like trust. You notice on our currency, it says, in God we trust. In God we have faith. It's whatever. So, that's it. You know, just remember, you keep telling me that God is watching everything, and while you're being evil as shit. You know, that's just really fucking hilarious. You lack that self-awareness that you're evil can be perceived by a simple human like me. I'm not God. I'm not anywhere close to it. And I'm aware, fully aware of your evil nature. But you're not. That means you're fucking crazy.